This one's title, I Found Out My Wife Cheated, and the Daughters Knew About It. The wife never gave me any suspicious behavior. We've always been a strong couple, married 25 years, three daughters, 17, 20, and 23, or at least I thought, or did I find out? One day, I received a message from a woman telling me her soon-to-be husband confessed that he cheated with a senior colleague at work. He came clean and gave the name of the woman, so she did a little bit of digging and found me. She thought I deserved to know the truth. I don't know if she did that to get back at my wife or genuinely thought I deserved to know, but that's not important. Obviously, I didn't believe her at the beginning, but as she gave me more details about the affair, the dates, duration, name of coworkers who knew, etc. So it does appear to be true. The guys gave her all the details. Hotel name, even the address of my freaking house, as she invited him. Her phone number, and so on. So yeah, at some point, I had to face the truth. The guy was 21 at the time, a kid, still can't believe she slept with a kid. It happened when I was on a business trip. Classic. When I put things together, I realized that she probably planned this as my business trip was scheduled months in advance. I find it odd to believe that it's a coincidence that she suddenly cheated at the same period of time while I was away. Wife is dead to me. I'm ready to divorce her, so I'm just preparing it, financials, etc. One of my good friends faced the same issue, so she advised not to confront my wife as she may go nuclear if she's concerned. I don't think she will, but who knows? I thought I knew her. Turn out, I do not. It's been hard to see her every day acting like nothing happened. She's planning our next holiday, talking about going to visit our daughters. Our eldest works in a different city, and the second one is in college. The youngest is finishing high school. She's like a flatmate now. I just don't feel anything. I'm a ghost living in our house. I wake up at 5, go to the gym, go to work, I have my own business, come back around 7 p.m., and just do my own stuff. I kinda think the wife is feeling something is weird, but I don't really care. What hurt the most, and that's where I need advice, is that my daughters knew about the affair. The soon-to-husband told his girl that my daughter walked in on them while they were kissing in her living room. Wife thought she would be at school all day. Apparently, she managed to calm down the daughter and explain the situation. Not sure what happened, but the daughter never told me anything. So I'm not sure what the wife told her to keep the secret. Knowing how close she is with her two sisters, I'm 100% convinced she shared the secret with them. And the three of them probably decided to keep it quiet. That's probably why I feel so detached. I believe I was, still am, a good father. I worked really hard on my business to make sure they get the best of everything. I put them first in any decision about my business to make sure I can provide, send them to college free of debts to give them the best start in their working life. I tried to be there at every step of their life. Basically, what any father would do. We had our ups and downs, obviously, but nothing major. They're my baby girls. And I always saw them as my little princesses. So knowing that they knew really stings. Part of me thinks they didn't tell me because they were scared of destroying the family. I understand that. But still, I have this anger inside of me, and it keeps growing. We have a WhatsApp group. And when I see them asking for advice, asking to help for a deposit for a flat and so on, I just feel like screaming and confront all of them. But I know it won't solve anything. It will just be a 10-second, happy feeling for me, and then it will go back to sting. Another part of me just wants to leave. Close my bank account and just leave the house, cut ties with all of them, and just leave without a word. My good friend advised against that because the law doesn't take this kindly. But really, I can't say that this option is not growing on me. I don't even want to talk. I don't want to understand their point of view. I want to leave and go somewhere like Thailand. Stay on a beach for a few months. And maybe one day, I'll feel ready to listen, or maybe I won't. I don't want to hear about how sorry they are, how they regret they didn't tell me. They had 3 years. For 3 years, they looked at me in the eyes and didn't say a thing. I really don't know how they managed to keep a poker face like nothing happened and still behave as usual. I feel like the four of them are master manipulators, and this anger inside me is not going away. What would you guys do if you were me? Reconciliation with the wife is out of the question. She repulses me, and the fact that she behaves like a loving wife just adds to the fire inside of me. I'm glad my friend helped me and talked to me about her experience, so I managed to see this from an outside point of view. Where I need advice is about my daughters. As I said, part of me wants to talk. Another part just feels like they don't deserve a chance to come clean now. It's too late. I'm just so lost. Thanks for reading all of that. It took me forever to put that on paper, but somehow it does feel good. The lawyer told me that since the kids are grown up, there won't be any alimony issue. As for spouse support, she might ask for it, but since she works and is doing fine for herself, the judge will most likely turn that down. Our joint account is only used for things that we pay as a couple. Otherwise, we have our own bank accounts. That was a strong advice from my parents that if two partners are working, they should not put everything in a joint account. Can't thank them enough for that. Lawyer said she could argue that my business is doing well, and she is entitled to a part of it if I happen to sell it. But since she works, we can always argue about this. To be honest, I don't even care. Talk to my daughters. I know I should. You guys are 100% right. The reason I've not done it is because I have this anger inside me that is not going away. I feel like if one of them says something that doesn't go well with me, I might snap. And, yes, I would like to believe my wife manipulated them to keep the secret, so me snapping will make it worse. Yes. The anger is misplaced. But just to be clear, obviously, I hated my wife when I learned it about the affair, but then anger turned into indifference. I will divorce and she will be gone. With my kids, it's different. I can't hate my kids. I have feelings for them. Unfortunately, right now, it's anger. The reason I assume my youngest shared it with the two others is because they have always been so very close to each other, supporting each other, which makes me very proud. So it's hard to believe my youngest didn't share it. But as someone said, I'm not 100% certain. In any case, I don't want to blame them. I understand their point of view if they tell me they didn't want to break the family, etc. But it's hard to accept the lying. It's like someone wrote, part of me would feel they sided with their cheating monk. I feel like I need some time alone to process everything. Time I didn't have lately. Between a wife, three daughters, a business to run, my only me time is the time at the gym to allow myself to have. But I don't feel that's enough to make the anger go away. And in my current situation, it'd be weird if I tell him I will be away for a month and then go to Hawaii. Paternity tests, STDs, etc., health checks, or no-brainer. I have an appointment at a clinic, and I'll do all the tests needed. Virginity tests? I don't know. I mean, what's the point? Worst cases are not my flush. Does that matter? I raised them for 20 years, they're my daughters. Being blood related is not relevant. If they are not, then it's on the mother, not them. I can't hold them accountable for that. Maybe the lady who contacted me lied. That was my first thought. I mean, three grown daughters, I thought we were a strong couple. My first reply was, I'm sorry you're going through this, but I don't believe your story about my wife. Then she started giving more details, more proofs. As I said, I don't care if it was because she wanted to ruin our marriage, but as the details are coming, doubt started getting into your head, and it's not going away. I started my own investigation, and as you can imagine, it's a lot easier to find clues when you know what you're looking for. I'm not one to live in denial. Facts are facts. And as much as it hurts, you have to face the truth. From what I understood, she and the guy were preparing their wedding. I don't know what happened to him, but it seems that he had this urge of coming clean. God knows what happened in his mind. Cut ties with all of them and move on. I assume these comments are from people with no kids. You can't walk away like that. What I meant is I would leave for a period of time to process everything. And when I'm healed, we would talk. But, yes, it won't be the same. I love them. They love me, but it won't be the same. However, no matter how angry I am, I feel like I can't just leave like that. If my youngest didn't actually share the secret and kept it to herself, me leaving will be devastating for her, and my other two might resent her for that. This is my nightmare scenario. I might be an idiot for thinking that, but my role as a father is to protect them. I will get the lawyer to speed up the paperwork and get my wife served. Then on the day she receives the papers, I'll Skype with my daughters. They're all in different states so we can have a discussion to clear things. I want to do this on the same day so that they don't go talking to their mother, and then she'll try her best to play the victim. I want her to believe I know nothing until I'm ready. It's Sunday now. I hope by next week, all the papers will be ready, and then I can finally open up and have a discussion with my girls. Let's see how it goes. I didn't expect to receive so much support, so I will make sure to update you once there are significant updates. Maybe my situation will be helpful for someone else, but I do hope nobody has to go through that and look for advice. All right. Here's the update. As many of you suggested, I took my youngest daughter for lunch last week. During that lunch, I asked her if there was something she would like to share with me. I don't know if it was my face or tone, but she immediately understood what I was referring to. She broke down and told me the whole story. She did see her mother kissing another man a few years ago in her home. Apparently, my ex-wife told the man to leave and sat down with our daughter. She explained that it was a brief lapse in judgment, but she was glad that our daughter stopped it. She swore it was a one-time mistake and begged her not to say anything to me, as knowing me, I would just walk away from her and her family. My daughter told me that she agreed to keep it a secret and she believed her mother. Later on, she shared it with my two other daughters. As you can imagine, they were both shocked. Apparently, my eldest didn't believe the story of the one-time kiss. It was too convenient that my youngest happened to walk in the living room and find them kissing for the first time. She told them not to worry and that she will handle it with her mother. I can't be more proud of her for taking this burden on her shoulders. From what my youngest knows, it seemed that my eldest talked to their mother about her cheating on me and that if she doesn't come clean to me, they would inform me. However, the mother always had a good excuse over the past few years to delay it. Either it was our job situation, a sick relative, etc. There was always a good excuse to explain that it would be devastating to add this on top of what is going on with me. At the end of the lunch, I told her I will call her two sisters to discuss. She insisted to be part of the conversation. Fair enough. I messaged my two daughters telling them I need to talk to them right now. So we quickly set up a call. Part of me thinks they knew what I wanted to talk about. And I told them that their sister told me about what happened with their mother. They both started crying, saying they are sorry. They wanted to tell me, etc. Long story short, I told them I was not mad at them. I said I was sorry they had to carry this burden for so long, and that I will always love them. When it comes to their mother, I told them I will leave because I don't see myself staying with someone who betrayed me. But I said I will talk to her first before making any decision, as it is the least I can do. I asked them to not mention anything to their mother, as I am planning to have a discussion the same evening. End of the day, I go back home. The wife is already here talking about her day as usual, etc. I told her I had an interesting discussion with our daughter. She immediately knew what I was talking about. She started sobbing, saying it was just a kiss. And because she knows how much I value trust and so on, especially with my business. She was afraid of losing me for such a small thing. To be honest, I thought seeing her crying would make me cry. But nothing. I told her she will receive the papers tomorrow by courier, and we will move on. After that, I went to our bedroom, packed some clothes, and left. I don't know where I was going, but I just couldn't stay in her home anymore. I booked a hotel downtown and called my youngest to tell her I would not stay at home tonight. She told me she was planning to stay with a friend tonight to avoid going back home and facing her mother. But since I was out, she asked if she could stay with me. Of course. I informed my two other daughters that their sister and I will be staying at a hotel for the night. They asked if we could discuss this all together, so I said yes. During that discussion, I told them what would be the next steps according to my lawyer. I also made sure they know they are my daughters and that I love them. Against probably everyone's advice, I couldn't stop myself telling them that part of me was hurt that they didn't tell me anything. I told them I thought we had a strong bond and that we could discuss just about anything. They started crying and apologizing, so I reminded them that no matter what happened, they're my daughters, and I love them. However, I told them it will take some time for me to behave as we used to. I told them I was thinking of going for a long trip to clear my mind, and my eldest said that if I needed it, then I should do it. After that, we just went to bed. The next morning, my daughter and I were having breakfast and the mother called me. I didn't really want to pick up the phone, but the daughter insists that I talk to her. I agreed, but I put the speaker on. As soon as I picked up the phone, I could hear she's been probably drinking all night. She started crying, telling me she loves me, we are meant to be together, this will be devastating for the kids, etc. I told her the kids are adults now. They don't need us. We gave them the best we could. And now they have built their own life. Suddenly, she turned very nasty, saying she will take everything I have, that she will make sure my company goes bankrupt, she would tell our daughters I physically abused her, etc. I was so shocked. I just stared at my daughter, who also couldn't believe what she was hearing. I decided to cut the discussion short and said my lawyer will get in touch with her. Daughter and I didn't even know what to say to each other. It's like the person who was with us for 2 decades suddenly became another person. 5 minutes later, she received a message from the mother telling her they need to talk. Daughter was scared, so I told her not to reply. Anyway, their mother was clearly drunk, so nothing good would come from that discussion. I told her I will be staying at this hotel until things are settled, and she's free to stay with me if she wants. We had another group call with my two other daughters to tell them what happened. As you can imagine, they were astonished. I met my lawyer and told him what happened. He said, I don't have to worry about anything. The mother had a good position professionally and is financially all right. I run a business that employs 50 to 100 people, so a judge will never jeopardize that, knowing her comfortable situation. She would get half of our assets, houses, cars, etc. But money-wise, she wouldn't have a penny from my savings, so she shouldn't be able to claim anything from my company. My daughter told me she's worried about going back to our house with her mom as she's afraid she will be blamed for it. I told her I'll get a place downtown, and she can stay there with me. Either temporarily until she feels she can go back or until she goes to college. I feel like the way her mother went crazy on the phone deeply troubled her. I will tell her I can find someone she can speak to if she feels the need, like a counselor. Let's see how she feels. The mother received the papers and apparently went ballistic with our families, hers, and mine. Her family tried to call us, but my eldest just shut them down. On my side, my brother knows me and just offered support. He knows I wouldn't do something like this for no reason. So here we are now. Divorce is on the way. Daughter is staying with me until she feels like going back home, maybe. The mother sent me messages. I might meet her, but my lawyer strongly advised me not to. He said there is nothing to gain and everything to lose, so I'll probably trust him of that. About me, I will not go to Thailand until I'm sure my youngest is in a good place. So if I go, it will probably be next year when high school is done. I don't know how our day-to-day life is going to be. Let's see.